you know, one thing I've always loved about Flat and Scruggs' sound, really the music was much more major key, kind of like Travis said, more laid back, almost more, less edgy and just more kind of happy in a way. Now, of course, the music was so convincing and the playing was so incredible, but the vibe of the music was something that really appealed to me. I remember the first time I heard it thinking, wow, this is such a complete vision of how the banjo can bring music to life. But I had no idea that this was the originator of this style. And to me, that's always been the thing that stands out about Earl. Not only is he an incredibly world-class musician and left such an indelible mark, but among the bluegrass musicians, his playing, which there's really no precedent for, and he sort of came out of nowhere and the perfect blueprint for how the banjo was supposed to articulate this music, gospel music, country music, blues, just like popped into his head and he had it figured out. And still to this day, bluegrass banjo players try to emulate Earl Scruggs note for note. And that makes him very unique because compared to the other instruments like Bill Monroe, there still are some people who definitely emulate Monroe, but you look at how the instrument has evolved. You look at guys like Chris Thiele and these incredibly technical players, and Dobro started, you know, with Josh Graves and then evolved all the way to, you know, Jerry Douglas and Andy Hall and all these other guys who do it in such a more refined way. And of course these are such influential players, but what Earl did still stands up to this day. And there really aren't any other musicians I can think of who hold that kind of legend status where they figured out how to do it and the style that they created, which there was no precedent for, still to this day is kind of like the gold standard of banjo. And when I think of other bands like the Johnson Mountain Boys or Michael Cleveland and Flamekeeper is a great example of a modern day band that really has kind of kept this element of the music alive. And you know, when we were getting ready to do our tribute to Flat and Scruggs, that was one thing that I was really excited about. And you can hear it in the songs. There is, you know, there are bluesy elements that come in and out, but the songs and the general vibe that they portray, there's something very consistent, very cool, very laid back, and very, very quintessentially Flat and Scruggs about all of that.